我作品当中的女性比较多，
嗯，
如果我要推荐演员的话，很可能我就会推荐女演员，
嗯，
这个我太太不会高兴的。
那你可以征询您太太的意见啊。
没有，我不参与这个事情，我永远不参与这个事情。
那有没有一些角色，比如说你在创作的时候，可能是那他像那个，这部电影的话，很多是所谓的杜撰的吧，就是要去想象的。有没有一些是你的作品里头，你希望是或者他本身就是来自于生活的、接触过的一些人物，有这样的一个情况吗？在你的作品里面反映真实人物？
我几乎每一部作品都是虚构的，我不太习惯把身边的朋友、家里的亲人，把他们作为这个小说的对象写到生活里面去。大概在10年前，我的小说风格有了一个很大的变化，就是由想象更多的这个转入写实。那么写实的作品呢，如果你写得比较成功的话，你会让人觉得哦，这个人物非常生动，好像在生活当中就有这么一个人一样。青衣啊，玉米啊，平原呢，推拿啊，这几个我比较重要的作品发表之后，经常有朋友问，谁谁谁是不是你的一个朋友？这些都不是真的。
Just to quickly summarize two main points that he raised earlier on. The first point is regarding adaptation of his work. And he has named two of his work, namely 青衣 and 推拿. I know the direction.
青衣就是The Moon Opera. The Moon Opera, 青衣。
Moon Opera.
Moon Opera. 那个玉米就是 Three Sisters.
Oh, Three Sisters, 玉米。
Yes.
And they were adapted into television work. So Wayne was askingFeiyu, will you be involved in the process of translating it to screen? And he says he tries to, he will give his opinion on the writing, but he will try to stay away when it is the director's job, like in terms of casting or choosing the actors. And then, just to share a funny anecdote, he knows mostly actresses, Niu Yuan Yan, but it wouldn't be good if he was to pick the actresses. His wife would not be happy. And the second point is his writing style has become more realistic, more realist over the years. Yeah, as compared to his writing style from before.
Okay, Tommy. Hi, you're done.